Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create your own custom gold medallion coin, including how to add custom wraparound text. This tutorial is in two parts. In the first part, we'll create the base medallion and prepare the person to place into it. In part two, we'll stamp the person into the medallion, transforming its texture, and add the wraparound text. This tutorial is an update of one I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. I provided this marble texture that you can use for your background. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Open a photo that you'd like to make into a medallion coin. It could be color or black and white. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. To get the best results from the filters that we'll be using, we need to make the resolution of the photo 300 pixels per inch. To do this, go to Image and Image Size. Type in 300 pixels per inch. If the size of your image becomes too large, type in a lower amount in either its width or height. But first, make sure the chain link icon is on. I'll type in 1500 pixels for its height. The width automatically changes because the chain link is on. In this example, the image size went from over 94 megabytes to under 5 megabytes. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl+0 on Windows or Command+0 on a Mac. To correct the brightness and contrast of your photo, we'll use the Levels adjustment. But before doing this, let's convert the photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Click the icon at the top right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Levels. Slide the input white level to approximately the point where the histogram starts to rise and do the same for the input black level. If your photo is in color, click the Adjustment Layer icon again, and this time click Black-White. This removes all its color. Click the photo to make it active. The next step is to make a selection around your subject so we can separate it from its background. There are many ways to make selections, and your choice should depend on the characteristics of your photo. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool and drag the tool over my subject to select it. Once you make the selection, click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your subject. Shift-click on the top layer to highlight all the layers and convert them all into one smart object. Control-click or Command-click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. We'll fill it with 70% gray. Click the foreground color to open the color picker. In the brightness field, type in 70%, then click OK. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the empty layer with the foreground color. Convert the gray layer into a smart object so we can modify the filter that we'll be adding to it. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Grain. Make the Intensity 5, the Contrast 50, and the Grain Type Regular. Make the top layer active and open your Elliptical Marquee tool. Go to the center of the portion of your subject that you'd like to use for your medallion and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a selection. Don't release the keys on your keyboard yet. Add the spacebar key to reposition the selection. When it's positioned and sized to your liking, you can release all the keys. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Click this icon to open the blending options. Reduce its opacity to 30%. Then click OK. Shift-click on the gray layer to highlight it as well and convert the two layers into one smart object. Open the marble background I provided, or you can open your own background that you'd like to use. Just make sure its resolution is 300 pixels per inch. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with 40% gray. Click your foreground color, and in the Brightness field, type in 40%. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the empty layer with the foreground color. Before we begin making the medallion template, let's create center guidelines. Go to View. If you're working on Photoshop CS6 or earlier, I'll show you what to do in a minute. Click New Guide Layout. Type in 2 for the number in columns and rows, and make sure Center Columns is checked. Then click OK. For versions earlier than CC, go to View and click New Guide. Type in 50% for horizontal and click OK. Then go back to View and click New Guide. Tick Vertical and type in 50% as well. Make sure your elliptical marquee tool is active and go to the center of your guidelines. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a circular selection approximately this size. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Double-click the gray layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. Make the size 50 pixels and uncheck Global Light. Make the angle 130 degrees and the altitude 60 degrees. Open Gloss Contours and click the gear icon. Click Contours. When you see this message, click OK to replace your current contours with the new set of contours. If you don't see their names, click the gear icon again and click Small List. Since Small List is already checked here, I won't click on it. Click Ring Double. Make the highlight opacity 100% and the shadow opacity 60%. Click Drop Shadow and change the blend mode to Linear Burn. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle 140 degrees. Make the distance 35 pixels, the spread 5%, and the size 25 pixels. Make the opacity 30%, then click OK. Next, we'll add the inside template. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Control-click or Command-click on the layer mask to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Click the Chain Link button. This links the width and the height. In either field, type in 98%. To accept the transform, click the check mark. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Click the empty layer to make it active. We'll fill it with 50% gray. Click the foreground color, and in the Brightness field, type in 50%. Then click OK. Fill the empty layer with the foreground color. Double-click the top gray layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. Make the depth 52%, the direction down, and the size 90 pixels. Make the highlight opacity 57% and the shadow opacity 60%. Click Contour and open your list of contour presets. Scroll up a bit and click Cove Shallow. Click Drop Shadow. The distance and size are 8 pixels. Open Contour. Scroll down a bit and click Ring Double. Make the noise 25% and click OK. Next, we'll brighten it and add color. But first, to save space in the Layers panel, let's group the Medallion coin layers into a folder. To do this, Shift-click on the middle layer to highlight it as well. Then press Ctrl or Command-G. Name the folder whatever you'd like. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Color Balance. To restrict the adjustment layer to affect just the Medallion coin and not the background, click the Clipping Mask icon. Now, the adjustment layer is clipped to just the one layer beneath it. Click Shadows. Make the cyan red 20 and click the Tab key on your keyboard twice to go to yellow blue. Type in minus 61. Click Midtones. In the first field, type in 74. Click the Tab key and type in 25 and then minus 82. Click Highlights. In the top field, type in 26, then 25, and then minus 40. In part 2, we'll stamp your photo into it and add wraparound text. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.